Welcome to this video where we're going to learn how to use the Nano Banana API in Python to create an image generation app. For those of you who don't know, Gemini 2.5 Flash Image is a brand new image generation model by Google. It's also known as Nano Banana, and it's pretty crazy how good it is. You can use it to create brand new images from scratch just with a text prompt, like these three images here. You can also use it to edit existing images in any way you want. For example, adding furniture to a room, or turning a scene from day to night. You can even use it to combine multiple images, for example, to see what you would look like wearing different clothes. It's really fast, it takes about 10 seconds per image, and it's really cheap as well, around about 3 cents per output image. There is also a free tier, but just keep in mind that if you do use that, Google is then allowed to use your data for training. If you want to try it out for yourself, you can pop over to Google AI Studio and try it right now for free. So as you can see, pretty much overnight, there's a lot of great app ideas that have been enabled by this technology. That's why today I'm going to show you how you can start building stuff with this in Python using the official API. By the end of this video, we'll have a Python script we can run that will let us edit an image or even combine two or more images so that we can generate stuff like this directly with our Python code. Now, all of the code in this project will also be available in GitHub. Just check the video description for the link. All right. Let's get started. Before we can use the Nano Banana or the Gemini Flash Image API, we will need a Gemini or a Google Cloud API key. If you don't already have an API key, here's how you can get one quickly. First, you're going to need a Google Cloud project. Log into the Google Cloud console and then create a new project. I already have a project here, so my page looks different. But if you don't have a project already, you can just type into the search box, new project. And then there should be a button you can press to create a project. Then just go through all these steps until you have a project set up. Once your project is ready, go into AI Studio and make sure that you're logged in with the same account that you were using for your Google Cloud, and then click Get API Key down here. And once you click that, you can click Create API Key up here. You should now add this API key to your environment variable, but of course, keep it safe and just make sure that you don't expose it publicly. And while we're on the AI Studio page, I want to show you something here as well. If you're using this chat window to create images or remix images, you can actually click on this Get Code button at the top here, and that will give you an example code snippet for executing this exact chat interaction via API. And you can click on this tab if you want to get the code in different languages. And the project we're working on today is actually built from this example code snippet. We basically just copy and pasted it and then updated this to make it fit our project. So this is really useful. So now that we have the API key, let's set up the rest of the project. If you've cloned this project from GitHub, you should see something like this in your IDE. There's a couple of example images in our project that I've included in here in our images folder. And our app will be able to use the Gemini Image API to edit or combine these images together. And the source code is in here in this miximages.py file. The configuration and dependencies are specified in this pyproject.toml file. To set up the project dependencies, just run uvsync in your project folder, and everything should just be set up for you. And if you don't know what UV is, then I strongly recommend you checking it out. I have a separate video about it, which I will link in the description. But if you're not using UV or you want to set this up in an existing project of yours, then the only dependency you need to add is Google GenAI. Here's the commands to install them with either UV or pip. Now that the project's set up, let's take a look at the API code. Again, this is code that was directly copied from the example API code from the official AI Studio website. And I'm just going to scroll through, but the code itself is really low level. There's almost no external dependencies, and it just kind of shows you the most raw, basic way to call the API. Now, this is good if you want complete control and transparency over how it works, but the trade-off is that it's not really simple or intuitive to use. This one API call is almost 70 lines long, and there's no sensible abstraction. But if we scroll through it, there's a couple of important bits we can pick up. For example, here's how it sets up the API key. Here is the name of the image model it's using. And here's how we can add a text prompt to the request. Here's how we can add an image prompt to the request. This appears to be a list, so if we want to add multiple images, we could probably just add more of these. And we could see here as well, images are added as Base64 encoded data. Maybe if I made this video a year ago, I would walk through this code step by step and explain it in more detail, because we might need to understand it. But these days, maybe there's not much point in doing that anymore because we can just feed this example script into an AI agent and then get it to refactor it in a way that's useful for us. And that is exactly what I did here. I used Gemini CLI to update the script for me and abstract it into a way that I just want to turn it into a simple Python CLI. The prompt I use looks something like this. Using this example API call, create a high-level function that lets me pass in a list of image paths and a prompt. Keep the function simple and refactor all the other stuff into descriptive private functions. And I think that worked pretty well. Here's the results. We now have a remix image function that is only a couple of lines long and much easier to read. This will load up our Gemini API key environment variable. It will also use the same Gemini 2.5 flash image model, which is hard-coded for now, but that's fine. You can always change it or make it a parameter if you like. And it also lets us put in a list of images and a prompt. Then it takes all of this stuff and basically calls our wrapper functions to invoke the API. To load images from the file paths, Gemini CLI has also created this helper function for me. And it might look confusing if you don't work with MIME types or blob data often, but it just works. Finally, we'll wrap all this logic up inside a CLI. Here, I just use Python's inbuilt argparse module to manage that. The user will be able to pass in up to 5 images and an optional prompt text. We can also implement some smart defaults as well. For example, if you provide just one image without a prompt, we can try to enhance it. If you provide multiple images, we'll just try to combine them. Of course, you can always override the prompt with something more specific. And if we pop back into the project, you can see all of the code I showed you is here pretty much in this one file. The file is about 150 lines long, but each of the functions is easier to read. For example, in our main function, we've got our argument parser, and then we have a bunch of helper functions that we don't really need to know how they work because they're just implementation details. And finally, at the top, we've got our useful function, this remix images one, which contains our interesting application logic. So if I wanted to extend this to build an app, I'd probably do something similar to this and then just work at this level of the abstraction and just kind of leave all this low-level stuff the way it is. So if you want to check it out in more detail, all of the code is here. Now let's go ahead and run some examples to see how this works. First, let's see if we can edit a single image. Here's the command I'm going to use. I'm going to give it a picture of a man and ask it to put him in a suit and change the setting to an office. So let's take this into our project and open up our integrated terminal. And I'm just going to paste that command you just saw. And for reference, here is the original image of this man. So we're going to pass that in as the input and we're going to pass in the prompt. Wear a suit and change the background to an office. Now it's done, and let's check out the results. And wow, I think the results are pretty good. If you compare them side by side, it's the same person, and even the pose and the angle is still similar. So it respected our instructions really faithfully. For the next example, let's combine two images. Here's the command. We're going to pass in two image paths, and I can use a prompt if I want to, but in this case, I'm just going to leave it blank, which will make it apply our default prompt, which is basically just to combine the images in a sensible way. Okay, so switching back to our project, these are two images that I'm going to combine. I'm going to put the woman in the yellow jacket. And you can see the results are also pretty good here. The yellow jacket is combined perfectly into this image. Let's do one more final example. Here we're going to combine three images and also add a prompt to try to create something really specific. We're going to try to ask for a product advertisement. So here's the full command. It's going to take the image of the same woman, of a different jacket, and a soda bottle. And we're going to give it a custom prompt to make a flashy promotional ad for the soda using all of these images. So again, back in the project, here are the three source images that we're using as part of this prompt. Let's run that. And that is pretty awesome. And here are the results. I think it's pretty impressive. It followed our instructions quite well, this time using three images and a prompt. So now I hope this video has given you a pretty good idea of how you can use the Gemini Flash Image API from Python to create your own image generation logic. Now in my experience using it so far, there's going to be some use cases that are just really amazing, but also some that just fall really flat. That's normal with AI technology. It's just something that you have to be aware of and learn to work with. So that's pretty much it for this project. And remember, the code for all of this is in GitHub, and the link will be in the video description. If you enjoyed this video, then please subscribe for more stuff like this. There are no sponsors or affiliates on this channel. All this content is tailored for you. So let me know in the comments what you want to see next. Otherwise, I hope this was useful, and I'll see you in the next one.